Today I'm going to be doing a review of this Nerf Rival Blaster Knockout XX-100. This is a spring-powered blaster in which we put the darts from the middle and then we have to shoot. So basically, this blaster can hold 1, 2, 3, 4 rounds over here in the grip and 1 round over there. So it can hold 5 rounds, but the Nerf only provides it with 2. So why is this even happening? Instead, just give us 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. But they only give 2. So let's get into the features. This is a trigger open like this from both sides, from the left and from the right, so that both people can do it easily. And next, there's a lock that's in all Rival blasters. It blocks the trigger. I can't press it, how loud I press. And next is the panic. The prime is very hard, even for me, but I'm 11 and still it's hard for me. I have to pull it with both my hands and push it from. And then I get shoot. But there's one major problem I faced about the knockout. I'll show you. I'll load the blaster, put the dart in, put it in, and I'll show you the speed of it. Like, see. I'll shoot it there, and you'll see how slow. You can see the dart. Look, it didn't even come out, like, seriously. What is this? And now, I have to shoot it another time. Then, it goes. And you see, the ball didn't reflect. It just came under my table, so I have it back. That's such a bad problem. So this gets like 25 FPS in my game. I don't know why it does not happen in any other one. So that's just a personal problem, actually. Because you see the blue one, that does not have this problem. So just don't care about it. So I prime it, I open the place, and then I put the ball, and I have to push it a bit to the front so that it gets some feet seconds. Like, see now. Now it went way better. So after this blaster is primed, again, if you prime it, it will be very easy to do it. Or sometimes if you just pull it out, the prime can get unprimed. Like, if loaded it, if you pull it like sometimes, now it's unprimed. I can prime it again. I don't know why it's happening, but I guess this ruins the blaster. This blaster has a Rival tactical at the top. Tactical rail, I guess. And then no stock extension, there's nothing in the Rival like that. And no end strike barrel extension, it's a Rival blaster. So that's the overview about the Rival Knockout. So now I'm gonna be testing the FPS in my way. Push it in. Didn't even come out. Just got stuck. Now we do it again. Still goes in there very slow. Let's try one more again. So I have to do it with this prime. Either put it in, push it from, then shoot, or I prime it, push it in from. I'll tell you a fact about this. See, you are not allowed to put in the balls in my way. If you are not allowed, if in the ruin like mine, you can never do this. I'm gonna show this. Put one from here, close it, put one from the front, try, and then it's gonna shoot both of the darts. 3, 2, 1. There was absolutely no dart left. Both of them. One came to me and one went somewhere. Now let me tell you the FPS. So in my testing style, the one in which I open it, put the ball in, and push it out, in that it achieved 99 FPS from here. But if you put it from here, it gets 82 FPS. IDKY. But if we use the normal method, you're gonna be shocked by hearing this. Literal 24 FPS. Like really. From that Hot Wheels set to the guitar, not even that much. 25 FPS. From here, it will go and it falls down here. It can't even touch the curtains. That's so slow. But when I use my own technique, it goes 99 and 85 FPS. I don't know why, but 85 FPS or 82, whatever I said, it's just fine for the knockout. So I mostly do this and then shoot, because I don't want to waste my time opening it, pushing it in, and it's just annoying. So 82, 85, and 99, whatever I said, that's a good frame rate, but it takes a bit of help. I don't know, but let me test out the blue one, and I'll talk with you. I checked out the blue one, and the blue one, doing it normally, it gives it 93 FPS. And doing it my way, gives it 121 FPS. Like really, what is this? 121, is it airsoft? It never feels like Nerf. I shot myself so many times, and it still pains. I don't know why, but it's very OP like that. I put it in, open, I'll get the blue one and show you. Blue one, if I open it, put a dart in, push it front, it's way more greasy and better than the red one. And after that, prime it, and then you heard the sound. And you saw the reflection in the current. So it's way better, 121 FPS and 93 FPS. So I suggest buy a blue one, that's just my suggestion. Because let's compare the colors. Red and blue, like literally, which one looks better? Of course the blue one, right? Because that red and orange contrast doesn't just look good. I don't know why. It's my suggestion, but your opinion is first in your choice. So if you want my suggestion, then get the blue one. If you can buy both, then I suggest buy both of them. It looks cool. But if you want the red, you can go with it. So that's gonna be for the today's video of the review of Nerf Rival Knockout. The next is going to be a review of Nerf, Elite, and Strike, I guess. Rough Cut, Battle Camo, 2x4. But let me shoot. I've got two of these. I'm going to review each of them in the same video. So, I'll get that done. Bye.